Yesterday, I visited a place I hadn't noticed before. It was lunchtime, and I had nothing to do but wait for the next call for the next job that probably wouldn't come. The fog was rolling in off the bay, and rather than trying to drive in that pea soup, I decided to stop into a bar and grill and happened to be near where I parked. It reminded me of a little place I used to frequent when I was a gumshoe in Los Angeles. The food was decent, and the dames were friendly. The place was nothing out of the ordinary. Could have been torn from the pages of any magazine in any rack of any newspaper dealer on the Lower East Side. Until that day had changed my life forever. You see, I was sitting there, having my lunch. Reuben sandwich, dill pickle side with an Indian pale ale. Minding my own business and reading the sports page of the Chronicle when I heard this. Excuse me, is anyone sitting here? I looked up to see the greatest knockout since Ali versus Liston. Why, no, I said. Why do you ask? Because I'd like to sit here if it's okay with you. Sure, be my guest. She sat down and I continued to read the paper. A moment passed. When I glanced up, she was lighting a cigarette and leaning her gorgeous elbows on the small table between us. Aren't you going to talk to me? She asked. Well, you didn't say you wanted to talk, I replied. You only asked if you could sit down. I'm kind of busy right now. Busy doing what? She breathed a puff of smoke in my direction. Reading about some hockey team? She questioned. Her gaze was piercing. She leaned back. Her blue sequins of her tight dress sparkled in the dim light. Ahem, no, I said. Hockey isn't really something I follow. So what do you follow? She said. People mostly. Say, can I buy you lunch? She turned her gaze towards the door. Only if you want to. I may have to leave soon. I can't guarantee that I'll have time to eat it. I slid a menu toward her. She didn't look at it. She was looking at the television in the corner above the bar. I'll have whatever you are having, she said. After a pause, she added, do you know who I am? I thought about it for a moment, looked up from my paper to see her green eyes staring right through me. I could barely speak. Her porcelain skin and red hair were the perfect frame for those eyes. She leaned forward, a lock of her long red hair brushing the table. Sure. I know who you are, I said, returning to my paper. I knew from the moment you got out of that black limousine with the driver opening the door for you. I suppose you think that makes you special. I turned the page of my paper. I didn't think you noticed, she said. Well, I notice things. That's why I get paid. So, you think I'm special? Perhaps I'm special only in what I can do for you, she said. I can give you the greatest case you've ever worked on in your short, miserable little life. Now, let's not get personal here. I was just sitting here having lunch. You approached me, remember? She leaned in further, blowing another puff of cigarette smoke in my direction. You ever heard of a man named Conrad? She asked. Sure, I've heard of a guy named Conrad. His last name's Conrad, isn't it? Don't try to be funny. I'm here to help you. I put down my paper and leaned forward. I was close enough to that satin face and I could smell the perfume she was wearing. I also couldn't help but notice from the thin lines on her fragile face that she was tired, very tired. Help you with what? I asked. I already told you, she said. give you the greatest case you ever had and blow the roof off this town. So, I lean back. How do you know I work on cases? How do you even know who I am? And how did you find me? I didn't even expect to be here today. I'm surprised myself. She had a smug look on her face as the waiter delivered her sandwich, which the waiter left. She said, I've been watching you. You always drive by here about this time of day. Usually you don't stop, but this time you did. I thought I would take advantage of it. She looked at the sandwich and didn't touch it. Somehow I think I'm being taken advantage of, I said. That's an expensive sandwich I just bought you. You should eat it. I'm not hungry right now. I just want you to get on this case so I can sleep at night. You still didn't tell me how you know who I am or what I do. That doesn't make me comfortable. It doesn't make me comfortable when I pay for a lunch for a beautiful woman and she doesn't eat it. You think I'm beautiful, do you? A bit of her red hair made its way from her ear to her face. I wasn't necessarily referring to you, I said. It was a general statement. I moved the remaining bread crust towards the center of the plate of my sandwich. You hold yourself in pretty high regard, don't you? Shouldn't I? She asked. After all, I may be the one person who gets you out of this small-time job into another something that will make you famous. Can you tell me why I should trust someone who shows up without warning in a limousine right between the middle of my Reuben? You're not a very trusting person, are you? She said. No, I'm not. That's why I'm still in business. Fog was beginning to lift. Nearby, a trolley passed.